pray, gracious God, I thank you once more for your word, life, truth, for your word, peace. Bless us, dear one, as we celebrate your love. Amen. The first Sunday in Advent marks the beginning of our journey. The theme for the first Sunday in Advent is, I hope you figure it out by now, experiences and events and relationships the likes of which the world has not seen, because Isaiah lived in a troubled time and he said that it'll get better. You wait and see. We live in a world that is filled with trouble and toil. We live in a world where it's easy to get down. I know too many people who have this life perspective. Cheer up, things could be worse. We all cheered up, and sure enough, they got worse. Or remember, it's always darkest before it comes completely black. Now, as I know too many, I have too many people that I've encountered that have that kind of dark sense of the world, and I'm thinking the Christian perspective is different. It's a bit like this. I love them. There's a movie that was out a few years ago called The Great Marigold Hotel. And The Great Marigold, has anybody ever seen it? And the sense of the story is that this young man in India sets up a retirement community for folk in the British Isles. And I don't know about you, but he had posters, and he had pictures. And you know, about 15 years ago, Deborah and I were looking for a house, and they saw pictures of the house, interior, exterior. And when we got to the house, it did not appear the same place in the pictures. Or, have you ever gone to a hotel thinking the best and found less than that? Well, that's what our Brits experienced when they arrived at the Grand Marigold Hotel. It was still on the way to being done. Matter of fact, was pretty well on with God. The young man says, after they complain just a bit, it will be all right in the end. If it's not all right, it's not the end yet. I want to adopt that kind of philosophy. Then in the midst of who we are, what we're about in our day-to-day, it may not be as pleasant as we would want it to be. Sometimes I think if all people would only think more like me, it'd be a better world. But they don't. And we all must find ways in which we walk the same path and enjoy the same experience, appearing to be differently. But that's who we are. We're a variety of people. We're a mix of people. We're a delightful blending of God's perspectives about how the world ought to be and who ought to be in it. Prophet Isaiah spoke of a time to come when things would be different. My sermon title is Make Room for Hope. Unless we can begin to make room for hope in our lives, it will not come. Oh, I know many people have been troubled by the results of our election in earlier this month, and I know it's challenging new way, new world of looking at things. There's a lot of us are still a great deal back and forth. I have a colleague who was voted differently than I did, and he was complaining in a Facebook post that why can't we just get over that and move forward? And the next day he posted a negative post regarding what he didn't think about. to deal with their perspective and how it relates to the world above us. Hopeful people. Hopeful people focus on what is now and that it may become. You know, that's a strange, for many people, that text from Matthew today is a strange text. Warns about daybreak, warns about a thief in the night, warns about the coming of the kingdom, warns about the same coming. And it says, be ready, be ready, be ready. Well, the reality for me is that we are all in a state of readiness to allow Christ within us. We are all to be in a state of being at peace with who we are, and if I can be at peace with who I am, then I can possibly find ways in which I can be in peace with you, and with you, and with you, and with all of us. My goodness. Make room for hope. We cannot block it out. We cannot look at the dark side of things. We cannot allow, you know, we worship the one who is the light of the world that will never be snuffed out. Oh, we can put candles, we can light candles on a Sunday, we can extinguish them, but our reason for lighting never diminishes. His love that is Christ's. His love that is God's love. His love that is filled, with a sense of hope for all of humanity. We are a hopeful people. We worship one who is criticized. We follow one who is beaten. We pledge allegiance to one who was crucified. We walk with one who some thought dead, but he walked on ahead of us on this road to life. Oh, is there any more hope than the one that is found in the one that we follow? There is a life given out of God's hope for the world. There is a life given to teaching God's will for the world. Here is a life that says, in the midst of difficulty and challenge, even says to us, you know, some days you've got to pick up your cross and follow me. It won't be easy, but I am there. I am that light on the hill that cannot be extinguished. I am that light eternal that shines for you. I am that vision that you can have when you say to yourself and to a troubled experience about you, it can be done differently. And it's the old. The old hymn verse is this. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' love and blessedness. Thanks be to God who brings us to heaven, who shows us hope. Is home.